Hello and welcome to Ruchi's Town. This is a two-tier vegetable stand that I made with the things that were there at home during the lockdown.
So I want to show how I made this vegetable basket. So I took two crates like this, which were really old. So I fixed these two with the help of a wood piece like this. This is T-shaped, but I removed it and I put only this. So this is how I have fixed it. So I have put two screws here and two screws here. We can even put two of them here, one there and one this side, but I just wanted to keep it simple and it would look good. So I fixed it across, and those are the four screws that are holding the crates together, on four on each side. So after that, I have put white paint, which we had at home, all over, and further to which I have painted this fluorescent in color. So that is a paint, a spray paint that I had at home. So I used that and I have sprayed it. So if you look at this, this is basically a fruit and vegetable basket that I'm going to use. So I pulled this hook out of a hanger. I drilled a small hole and I screwed it in. It had a screw system, so I screwed it in. So I'm going to hang the bananas there. So that's the plan. It took me very less time. So it's just that I left it for 2 or 3 days for drying after every coat. That is only a time consuming thing. If otherwise, it was really fast. It's hardly like a half an hour's job to put everything together.
For fixing the wood strip on the crates, first drill holes and then screw. If you're nailing it, please nail carefully, as these crates are not of great qualities usually. If the crates were new, I would have left it in the wood finish, but these are old used one and it was all discolored, so I'm sanding them before I started painting.
So why do you need this painted white, Mommy?
That's primer.
Oh, wait.
The white coat dried for a day. The next day I started spray painting it with this color of paint that I had at home in stock. For anyone who is trying to do this, it would be better to first paint it separately and then assembling it. That would be very easy, especially when you are doing multicolor. So the stand dried outside for 24 hours and it's all ready. The final touch is screwing that hanger to hang the bananas. So first I decided I'll put it on the right side, but then I decided to put it in the place where the ending of the wood that we had screwed is there, so that even if it comes out of the crate, it would the wood would obstruct that. So that's the plan, and there you go, it's all done. I'm going to screw the hanger inside. So this is just my idea. You could be creative and do whatever you want in this. The crates can be even smaller, that would look much better, and you can even make three tier if that's required. See, I don't put onions into this because I have a different place to keep the onions. This is only for the potatoes, because they are, every time we buy potatoes, there are a lot of them, and I have a different basket that I had kept there. I wanted to do something on my own, and especially in wood or bamboo. So this is what I had, and I thought this is a good time to make this, and there it is, all ready. So this is a finished product, and this is how it would look if it is kept on the ground directly. However, I had a plant caddy which was lying at home, so I used it to place this on the caddy so that it could be moved anywhere I wanted easily. Mangoes, and this is for bananas. So we have only that much of fruits right now. So this is how the fruit basket is. I'm really happy with it. So I'm not going to fix it with that because I can remove the wheels whenever I want. So this will help me move when I have to clean. So this will go into my corner. And that's how it is. If you like this video, do like, share, comment, and subscribe to Ruchi Stuff.